first clue came from a Swiss astronomer named Fritz Zwicky, just a few years after the discoveries that had suggested the Big Bang. Zwicky noticed that these newly discovered galaxies were behaving oddly.
Fritz Zwicky looked at clusters of galaxies and found that the individual galaxies within those clusters are moving so fast that the clusters should fly apart.
Moving around so rapidly that it was impossible to understand why they didn't just wander away. Something clearly held them in these orbits.
Zwicky could see nothing in his telescope to explain it. So he called the phenomenon dunkla materia, translated as dark matter. And then the idea promptly faded away. Zwicky's observation might have ended up forgotten, and for nearly 40 years, it was. Until an astronomer named Vera Rubin entered the field.
Vera Rubin was one of these astronomers who was not appreciated until much later. She was a woman in astronomy at a time when the field was not particularly friendly to women.
Here's what we get.
She, too, noticed something bizarre happening.
The stars way out here are going very fast.
The stars at the edge of the galaxies were moving so fast that they should have been flung off into space.
Think about a spinning wheel covered in water. If the wheel is moving slowly, the water clings to the wheel. But spin it fast enough, the water flies off. Same thing should happen out in the universe. Stars swirling around in a galaxy. If they orbit too fast, they'll get flung off out into space. Except that's not what Vera Rubin sees.
The galaxies are spinning fast, but the stars stay in their orbits. What's holding them there? It has to be gravity.
Response, the gravitational pull from something not bright, and we don't know what that is.